Christ is risen from the dead. We are one with him again. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. So imagine going to a friend's grave and they've just died. And you show up to this tomb, and imagine all of a sudden the grave is empty. And imagine just all the emotion you must feel, the feelings, the anxiety, the confusion. And imagine it all too. Imagine that this person that you saw was doing all these things in the name of God, and things were happening. People were being healed. Dead people were rising from the grave, and this guy is saying, destroy it. You know, and all of a sudden you're looking at an empty tomb and you start remembering, you know, he said he was going to rise from the dead. He said in 3 days he was going to rise. He said the Son of Man must go down. And imagine for the followers of Jesus staring at an empty grave, at an empty tomb, all the different things they must have felt. And did they finally go, oh, that's what he meant? I don't even know if they probably didn't get it right away. It probably took a long time. They were probably freaked out at first because it was just a thing of, did somebody steal his body? But we know that somebody didn't. And in the middle of what seemed to be the darkest time in some people's lives, all of a sudden life started coming out of it. And I love the fact that God chose for his son to die for our sins and rise from the dead during spring. He could have done it any time. God really, he could have done it during winter, really, when you think about it. God could have picked any time, but no, he didn't. He picked spring. He picked the time of the year when literally life is coming out of the ground. And I think he did it because he's basically trying to use everything he could to constantly point us back to the single greatest revelation, that in the midst of death, in the midst of the reality of suffering in our lives, that Jesus Christ is risen. And that early Christians had to get together literally the night of the Passover. They would celebrate Passover, and then they would go and they would get together during the night, and sort of they would remember all the way through from the beginning of the story of God all the way through to Christ, and they would recall how all of a sudden, oh, you know what, all the prophets, this is what they were talking about, this is who they were talking about it, and they would celebrate it so that literally as the sun rose in the east, they would be celebrating the fact that Christ is risen. And 2,000 years later, we're still doing that. And every year, once a year, you know, we in a special way recall the gift and the mystery of what God did for us when he took our sin and he nailed it to a cross. And 3 days later, 3 days later, he rose from the dead. And so we rise with him. And this whole passage of Jesus Christ suffering, dying, and rising, some Christians call it a phrase called the Paschal mystery. It's a mystery. It's a mystery to enter into, and we're called to enter into the fullness of it. If you've been a believer and you've been following Jesus Christ for a long time, have you entered into the whole mystery? Have you united yourself with God in your suffering? Have you died to yourself in certain areas of your life with Christ? And are you experiencing resurrection? I heard someone once say, a surefire way to know that you are living in the will of God is if you are experiencing passion, death, and resurrection in your life. Not just one area, because God deemed it all important. So God wants you to experience it all. And that way too, if you are dying to yourself in a certain area of your life, you're going to experience real resurrection in other areas. And so I encourage you, as we join the whole church around the world, we join, you know, hundreds of thousands of believers who've gone before us in saying today to the world that Jesus Christ is risen, that in the middle of our dark times, that Christ is risen, in the middle of all the struggles that we face, that Christ is risen, and allow ourselves to truly enter into this whole season so that we can really experience resurrection in our life.